Hi everyone, my name's Katie Barlow and I'm from the Student Liaison Office at Lincoln University. Joining me today is Catherine Elliot, who is a senior lecturer from the Department of Tourism, Sport and Society, to tell us about the Bachelor of Sport and Recreation Management at Lincoln University. But before we get started, Catherine, please take a moment to introduce yourself and tell us about what you really enjoy about your subject area and your role at Lincoln.
Thanks, Katie. I really enjoy teaching sport and recreation management to the students. The main thing is that I get to know the students one-on-one, and I also get to network in the sport and recreation sector. So I get to talk with people who have what type of students that they're looking for, so I can prepare our students so that they go into the profession quite easily when they graduate.
Great. So let's take a little bit of a closer look at the Bachelor of Sport and Recreation Management. What can students expect to learn about?
Well, there's a wide variety of things that our students learn about. Everything from very basic skills, like feeling comfortable shaking hands with a professional in the sport and rec sector, as well as having understanding how professionalism can have a social impact with the jobs that they'll end up getting, and everything from how human rights and social inequality can be impacted by the sports that we play and the recreation that we choose to engage with, and even how national or global pandemics can be impacted on sport and recreation, and how that can be maybe one of the first things that we get back to doing when we get out of such things.
Yeah, absolutely. So can you tell me a little bit more about what classes are like and if there's any practical work involved?
Absolutely. Yeah, there's about 30 students in each of the classes that we teach within their degree program. And with regards to practical work, it is very practical. So the students, at least for the courses that I teach an event planning course and also the internship. And students in the internship actually get linked with someone in the sport or recreation sector, and they work 120 hours right directly under that person. And some of those actually lead into jobs. And with the event planning course, they actually get to make quite a thick event plan that could be eventually run by city or district council. So they get their hands dirty and they get to practice real things that they could be doing in the work in the sector when they finish.
Sounds good. And so if I graduate with this qualification, what kinds of careers could I get into? And is there a demand out there in the workforce?
Well, that's an interesting question because there's really two aspects of it. There's the sport and the recreation. So with sport, you can look at anything from community sport. Think about, I tell the students to really think about what they did as a kid. Who was the one that organized the tournaments and got the fields ready and ready to play? And then the recreation side of it, have they ever gone to a national park? Do they understand what it takes to run a national park and to keep tourists in the right spot, and what policies to make if things happen? You know, just about every dock ranger seems to have a Lincoln University degree. So it's actually quite the parks and outdoor recreation sector is a real strong, historically strong part of what we do at Lincoln. So getting students to get out there, not just in organized sport, but also leisure time recreation.
Sounds good. So lastly, do you have any subject advice for students looking to best prepare for courses at university?
Absolutely. I would say students should stick to computing type course can never go wrong. If there's a psychology or a social studies, sociology type course where you're learning about people, Maori studies is always important. New Zealand government policy, history, anything around business, accounting, those are also quite helpful. English is never, you can never go wrong with that. If there's health and physical education classes, those can be helpful, but that's not, the sport and recreation degree is not going, you're not going to learn a lot about human physiology. But there are courses that you can opt to take. And then just anything technology, even legal studies. And from the recreation side, if you're interested in more of the outdoors, I would specify that you could take some horticulture class, biology, earth science, a sustainability class that's becoming quite a prevalent thing in both sport and recreation, and science, as well as anything with the natural environment.
Thank you, Catherine, and thank you for joining us today.
Thank you so much, Katie, for having me.
If you have any questions or would like more information, just ask your careers advisor to put you in touch with your Lincoln liaison officer. And I will see you next time. Bye for now.